Understanding the horizontal gaze pathway provides the key to understanding the fundamentals of INO and 1.5 syndrome. Inputs for horizontal gaze reach the ipsilateral paramedian pontine reticular formation from the contralateral frontal eye field for saccades and the ipsilateral occipitotemporoparietal cortices for smooth pursuit. The PPRF then sends a signal to the ipsilateral abducens nucleus, which has two types of neurons. The larger motor neurons that project to the abducens nerve supplying the ipsilateral lateral rectus, in this case the right lateral rectus. The abducens nucleus also contains smaller interneurons that project to the contralateral medial rectus subnucleus of the oculomotor nuclear complex through the medial longitudinal fasciculus. From the oculomotor nucleus, the impulses are carried to the left medial rectus via the left oculomotor nerve, thus producing right conjugate gaze. If this horizontal gaze pathway is interrupted by a lesion in the left medial longitudinal fasciculus, the ipsilateral medial rectus cannot act on contralateral gaze, thus producing an adduction deficit. At the same time, due to Herring's law, the extra innervation to this medial rectus also flows to its yolk muscle, the right lateral rectus, thus producing a nystagmus in the contralateral abducting eye. This combination of an ipsilateral adduction deficit with an abducting nystagmus of the other eye on contralateral gaze is termed an internuclear ophthalmoplegia. In this case, it is a left INO. Convergence is preserved in most cases despite the adduction deficit. If the lesion is, however, large enough to involve the abducens nucleus and or the PPRF in addition to the medial longitudinal fasciculus, then additional findings are present. Because of the PPRF bar abducens involvement, there is an ipsilateral horizontal gaze palsy, and because of the MLF involvement, there is a left INO. So the left eye can neither abduct because of the gaze palsy nor adduct because of the adduction deficit of the INO. The right eye cannot adduct because of the gaze palsy. The only movement possible is abduction of the right eye, and this movement also has nystagmus because of the INO. This combination of a horizontal gaze palsy with an ipsilateral INO is termed Fisher's 1.5 syndrome, or simply 1.5 syndrome.